You need to talk to your son. He was poking around in the old Vandegrift house again. Said he found some secret room.
Yeah, really? Okay, I will go talk to him.
What did you do? What did you wake up?
Nothing! I found a room, I walked into it, that's it.
You can feel it, right? Something, something coming from the Vandegrift house.
Travis, leave the boy alone. I see how you've been looking at him.
You don't even know, do you? You have no idea what's going on. You have to help us. It's the only way. It wants Ethan.
You're crazy.
Pop. They're getting worse. They keep talking about this thing, this sleeper.
I know. What I don't know is if it's real or not.
It's not my fault. I didn't mean for any of this to happen.
Ethan's family blamed him. Whatever it was he'd accidentally let loose, his family was convinced that hurting him would solve their problems, would soothe their disturbed minds. Whatever haunted the Carters was still here somewhere, in the wind.
Come here for many reasons. They want to ask me questions about the future. But I can see the future. So it is the past that interests me. If you want to find my house, you must answer the questions I ask of you. Does sin come from the heart or the mind? Vanity, charity. Is betrayal caused by inequality or injustice? Would you rather be a leaf or a root? Does death bring peace or suffering? Do you admire leaves or bravery or their greed?
Ethan, the point of life is not to rock the boat. Just try to get along. Stop living in your head. Do something real. That's what people respond to. Reality.